There are some changes that a regular sync cannot handle, such as deleting a note type or modifying the number of fields. Here we can see that syncing is functioning normally. Let's add a new field to a note type to see what happens. This triggers a warning that making such a change will require a one-way sync, or, as it is sometimes called, a full sync. Before proceeding, please make sure all of your devices are in sync. Because the next sync can only go in one direction, any unsynced changes on other devices will be lost. After confirming we wish to proceed, and closing the window, let's sync again. Note the color of the sync button has changed to red, to indicate a one-way sync is required. We're presented with the same message we got when we initially set up syncing. Let's choose Upload to send our changes to AnkiWeb. Now we need to move over to any other devices we use. Sync. And choose Download. Once you have uploaded on the first device and downloaded on your other devices, all devices will be back in sync, and subsequent syncs will proceed as normal. It is also possible to force a one-way sync. While you should not need to do this frequently, it can be useful to recover from a mistake. For example, imagine you accidentally delete a deck. If you were to sync normally, the deletions would be sent to AnkiWeb. We can prevent this by forcing a one-way sync. We'll go to the Preferences and locate the Syncing section. Then we select the option to sync in one direction and close the window. When we then sync, instead of the deletions being sent to AnkiWeb, we need to choose which direction to sync. Since we want to overwrite our local changes with AnkiWeb's state, we'll choose Download. And once the sync completes, we see our deck has returned.